and Saul among the first of the kings among the Jewish people. And today we have the beginning of the what's called the Temple of Solomon, the Solomon feeling guilty and the Jewish people feeling guilty that the Ark of the Covenant was still somewhat of a portable thing. And they hear Solomon now having this nice castle and all of that to live in, so even more should God have a dwelling place among the people, and thus the Temple of Solomon, which would last about 400 years, because it would be destroyed by the Babylonians, who would take the Jews off into captivity. Later on, the second temple would be built, and that would be the one in which Jesus would spend some time, but it also would be the one that would be destroyed 600 years later from its building, when the Romans had destroyed the city of Jerusalem, not leaving a stone upon a stone. But what was left is now the holiest site for Jews, of course, what's called the Wailing Wall or the Western Wall, which is the last remnant, the foundation portion of the temple, the second temple. But the reality of Jesus finishing his work and the temple being destroyed shortly after that, about 40 years after Jesus' death on the cross, a reminder to us that even though we build our churches and have magnificent structures as well as very simple ones and everything in between, the reality is that the ultimate dwelling place of God is within each and every one of us as we seek to be those faithful, loving servants. Thanks to God for what we have in our places of worship, but even more to recognize more fully how we are called to take what we find here in word, sacrament, and community out into the larger world to be the real presence of Christ among us. Please stand.